and all. In the last class, we have started something which is very important, that is called a random variable. As I told you already, so the concept of random variable is very, very important. So now we are studying a discrete random variable. As I told you already, there are two varieties of random variable. One is continuous type and other one is discrete type. So first we'll study about discrete random variable. As I mentioned in the last class, random variable assigns a real value to the outcome of an experiment. So in this diagram, we can clearly see that. So this is sample space which contains all possible outcomes of an experiment, and so for those outcomes, a real value is being assigned with help of a random variable x. If the range, this is a range, if the range of the random variable is finite, it is called discrete. Otherwise, it is called continuous type of random variable. So we have taken some examples. So in the rolling die experiment, so the random variable could be sum of two rolls, because so if I say sum of two rolls, you can easily assign a real number to the outcome. Sum can be 2, 3, 4, 5, so on and so on. Correct? Now number of sixes in the two rolls. Here also it is very easy to assign a real number to the outcome, because outcome can be 0, 1, 2. Yeah, these are the different types of random variables. Yeah, so for every random variable, we have an associated what? PMF, probability mass function. Okay. How it is defined? It is defined that, so simply write like this. Px of small x equal to probability that capital X equal to small x. So please remember, this is a definition of PMF. So that is the definition of probability mass function. Okay. So what is small x? So small x is any possible value of capital X. What is capital X? It is a random variable, discrete random variable. Okay. Now finally, this is what PMF is defined. Okay. So we have solved this problem in the last class itself. I told you one more important thing regarding the PMFs. Sum of all PMFs over X should be equal to 1. Why? Because after all, this PMF is nothing but probability. So sum of all probabilities has to be equal to 1. So that's why sum of all PMFs should be equal to 1. Now, so we have seen some varieties of random variable. The first type is Bernoulli random variable. So in the previous classes, I mentioned Bernoulli trial, a trial whose outcome is only two possibilities. Okay, the best example is tossing a coin, where we get outcome as head or tail, only two possibilities. Now X can be modeled as a Bernoulli random variable, because it has got only two possible outcomes, either head or tail. If you get head, we assign a real number 1. If you get a tail, we assign a real number 0. Okay. Now this is simply assigning a real number to the outcomes. Okay. So this is the simplest form of a Bernoulli random variable, which is a discrete type. Now corresponding PMF is what? Very simple. Okay. If it is a biased coin, so what is the PMF defined actually? Suppose if I say Px of 0, which means probability that capital X equal to 0. Which means, what is capital X? Head. So, we are, capital X equal to 0 means what? Getting a tail. Sorry. Capital X equal to 0 means what? Tail. So, probability of getting tail is how much? Q. Or 1 minus P. Suppose if I say Px of 1, which means probability that capital X equal to 1. So, capital X equal to 1 means getting a head. What is the probability? P. So it's the corresponding PMF. If you add these two things, you should get 1, because sum of all PMFs should be equal to 1 for various values of small x. Here, So we are summing all PMFs by changing what? This small x value. Now, so the another type of random variable is binomial random variable. So we have also defined about this binomial probabilities in the previous classes. So without wasting much time, I am writing directly. So the binomial random variable, something like this. Okay. So here also sum of all PMF should be equal to 1. So as I mentioned in the last class itself, sometimes we denote PMF as px of small x, or sometimes we write px of small k. Both are valid. Both are all right. Okay. Either we use this notation or this notation. So please don't get confused. Both are correct. So another type of random variable is geometric random variable. So now generally this is modeled by using experiment where we get success or we get head for the first time, which means how many attempts are required to get head for the first time. Okay. Now PMF is very simple. We have seen in the last class also. Now another type of random variable is Poisson random variable. So you just remember its PMF, e power minus lambda into lambda power k by k factorial. Here I am writing px of k equal to. Okay. So what is this lambda? I will tell you later, but that is a very important parameter of the Poisson random variable. Okay. So generally we use this Poisson random variable to find out number of telephone calls over a fixed duration. Okay. So to find out how many calls received over a fixed duration, number of winning tickets among the those purchased in the large lottery, otherwise number of printing errors in a textbook. Okay. So to find out those kind of things, generally we prefer Poisson random variable. So we have solved one problem. What is that? We are finding number of accidents over a fixed time. See, please remember what is being asked here. So what is the probability that at least one accident in this month? So we are finding the probability for at least one accident in a fixed time. What is the time? Over a 1 month. It could be 1 year or 1 day also. Okay. So to solve those kind of problems, we model them as a Poisson random variable. Now these are the functions of random variable, where one random variable is function of another random variable. Why? Because generally, again, y equal to g of x means, so y is a function of random variable x. Now it can be in two different ways, either linearly or non-linearly. Okay. Now, so generally what will happen is, so there is a relation between random variable y and random variable x. So we know its PMF, it is given to us. So we know PM of x, it is given to us. You have to find out what? PMF of y. Which means, so probability mass function of one random variable will be given to you. You need to find out PMF of another random variable. Okay. Now, so we have solved this problem. Here, the relation between two random variables was mod operation. So we have solved this now. So let us move on to one of the important parameter of a random variable. What is that? Expectation or mean. So we represent this as mu x or mu simply. If I write mu subscript x, means what is x here? Random variable. Otherwise we can omit this subscript, just we can write mu also. Okay. So if there is only one random variable, I simply write mu as a mean. Okay. So this is a general notation for the mean or expectation. So it is nothing but average value generally. Average value of x. Okay. You know how to find average of given numbers. What do you do? total sum of all numbers by those numbers. Suppose if I ask you, what is the average of 1 and 3? What will you do? 1 plus 3 by 2. Isn't it? So, in the crude way, so mean is nothing but average. Okay? So, in layman language, I can simply say that mean or expectation is just like average, finding average of given numbers. Okay? Now, to find out average, we should know what? PMF. Now, this is a formula for finding the mean or expectation. So, this can be denoted as mu x or mu. Now, so we have seen nth moment. This is the nth moment. Okay. How to find that? So, expectation of exponent is nothing but what is called as nth moment. How do you find as x power n px of x? So please make a note of this. This is the nth moment, but we are using what? What is this? This is still probability mass function of what? X only. Okay, that's why I've written here. There is no need to calculate probability mass function of x power n. So, in order to calculate nth moment of any random variable, we use only probability mass function of x only, not x power n. Okay, only we say is x power n into px of x, summation over small x. Okay, so we'll discuss in detail about these things later. But for time being, just remember this formula. What is that? So, expectation of x power n is nothing but nth moment of a random variable, which is defined as summation over x, x power n into px of x. Okay. I think we have solved this problem already. I hope so. Now, so let us start today's class with a new topic. So, that is called variance. Okay. Actually, for every random variable, there are two important parameters. The first one was mean or expectation. The second one is variance. So it is denoted as what? Sigma x square. X is what? Random variable. Okay. What is variance? Variance is nothing but expected value of the random variable x minus expectation of x whole square. Now, so let us solve this. So, variance equal to expectation of or mean of random variable x minus expectation of x whole square. Okay, so actually this is called deviation. Why? Because it is deviating from what? Mean. Okay. Anyway, so we'll write everything in detail later. Now, here I told you expectation of x we can denote with what? Mu or mu x. So, without using generality, I will write just mu. Okay. So, variance of x equal to expectation of what? What random variable? X minus mu whole square. In place of expectation of x, I am writing mu, or mu or mu x, both are alright, but so for simplicity I am writing mu. Okay. Now, but we know that from the definition of mean, expectation of any random variable x equal to, what do you write? Summation over x, small x into px of x. Now, so what is the expectation of this? So remember this basic formula. Okay, remember this basic formula. So from this basic formula, what I want to ask you is, what is this variance of x equal to? variance of x that is also equal to sigma x square, that equal to expectation of x minus mu whole square. But what is general formula of expectation of x? This is a general formula. So based on the general formula, can you write the formula of this expectation? Okay, so let us try. I want to write expectation of x minus mu whole square equal to, what do you write? So in place of x, we have what? X minus mu whole square. Okay, so we make comparison between these two. Equation 1, let us call. So based on this formula, you should write formula for this. How to write? Summation over x. Summation over x. So one more thing I have to tell you is, expectation of, generally your expectation will be a constant. You get some number. Okay. Summation over x. Then what do you write? Here mu is a constant, a number. Then what do you write? Small x minus mu whole square into px of small x. Now this is a formula of expectation. You just try to understand things logically. No need to remember any formulas here. You know this formula. Just in place of capital X, here I have what? X minus mu whole square. So whatever is here, I have written here. Here, whatever is here, I have written here. What changes I made is, here it is capital X, here it is small x. In the same way, what changes I made here is, here capital X, I made it small x. Everything is same. Capital X minus mu whole square is written as small x minus mu whole square. Here what happened here? Capital X as written as small x. Now this is same everywhere. Okay? Now simply, so the variance of x is, formula is, so I am going from basics. Variance of x equal to, that is also equal to sigma x square equal to, simply the formula is summation over x, x minus mu whole square, px of x. Now here, let us expand this square term. Expand this. Summation over x, what do you get? X minus mu whole square. X square plus mu square minus 2x into mu into px of x. So let us separate, let us write separately. Summation over x, x square into px of x plus summation over x, mu square into px of x. Isn't it? Third term is minus 2, that is constant, keep outside. Summation over x, x into mu into px of x. Okay. Now, here, first term, okay, that is okay. In the second term, mu square is also constant. I told you already. Mu square is nothing but square of the mean. If mean is constant, its square also will be a constant. Now here also, what is constant? Mu is constant. So if something is constant, you can take out of the what? Summation. Now you can write this as summation over x, x square into px of x plus mu square into summation over x, px of x. In the third term, you can take mu outside the summation because it is constant. Summation over x, mu into px of x. Now here, we can use some of the basics of the PMF. What is this? What is this? This is sum of all PMFs. That has to be equal to what? 1. Okay. I think I made a mistake here. I'm sorry. It should be what? Should be x. Okay. Now, now it can be further rewritten as finally variance of x equal to summation over x, x square into px of x plus simply mu square minus 2 into mu into summation over x, x into px of x. Here also we have one more clarity. What is this? Okay, what is that? So let me write in one more page. Finally, what we got here is sigma x square. Finally, we got as summation over x, x square into px of x plus mu square minus 2 into mu into summation over x, x into px of x. What is this? What is that? It is nothing but expectation of x, also called as mu or mu x. So finally, what will happen here is sigma x square or variance of x equal to summation over x, x square into px of x plus mu square minus 2 into mu into mu. It is not mu x, so don't get confused. 2 into mu, isn't it? Because this is also equal to mu. Finally, it will be equal to summation over x, x square into px of x minus mu square minus 2 mu square minus mu square. I am writing the simplified form. But finally, what is this? What is this? This is the second moment. Isn't it? Just now I told you, nth moment is nothing but expectation of x power n, that equal to summation over x, x power n, px of x. So if n equal to 2, what would happen? Expectation of x square equal to summation over x, x square into px of x. Precisely this is equal to what? Expectation of x square or second moment. Now finally, so variance of x equal to expectation of x square minus mu square. But what is mu equal to? That is expectation of x. Finally, so the variance of x equal to sigma x square equal to expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. So please make a note of this. This is what finally the formula of variance of a random variable. Okay. So don't get confused. Here, this is the second moment. This is the mean. Mean square, actually. Square of the mean. Okay, one more thing. So variance is always non-negative. It should be. Why? Because why? Here, what is happening? This is the PMF, right? In this definition of the variance, this is PMF, means probability is always positive. Isn't it? What about this term? It is square term. What is written at? X minus mu whole square, isn't it? It can never be negative. So that's why variance is always non-negative. It can it be 0? Yes, it can be 0. Okay, variance can be 0 or positive, but it can never be negative. Why? Just by looking at this equation. This is a probability, it should be positive. This is square term, which can never be negative, but it can be 0. Okay, when it is 0, you find out. Okay, when the variance is 0, that is your homework. Okay, now, what does variance indicate? It is a measure of dispersion or deviation from mean. It's a deviation from the mean. I will elaborate about this later, but just for time being, it's a deviation from mean. So if you look at the definition of variance, this is a definition, right? What you're finding? Summation over x, x minus mu whole square, px of x. Now this is a deviation, x minus mu. We are finding deviation from whom? From mean. This is a mean mu. So I will explain later about this, but just remember it is a dispersion, or it measures dispersion or deviation of a random variable from its mean, around its mean. Yeah. So variance in terms of movements expression is, this is the final formula of variance, which is very, very, very important. Okay. Now, so we have one more term that is called standard deviation. What is standard deviation? Square root of the variance. Okay. If sigma x square is variance, sigma x is the standard deviation. SD, simply we call. What do we call it as? SD, standard deviation. How it is defined? Square root of variance of x. Okay, so total we have three parameters for any random variable: mean, variance and standard deviation. Anyway, so standard deviation is not a new parameter, it is just square root of the variance, but it has very significance in the probability course. Now, so this is very, very important. Expectation of x square always greater than or equal to expectation of x whole square. Why it is so? Yeah. So let us go back to the mean variance formula. What is variance formula? Two things are important. This is a variance formula. And one more thing is variance always non-negative. Which means what? It is always greater than or equal to 0. Okay. So if it is so, what would happen? Combine these two. So this is a variance formula. Sigma x square always non-negative, which means always greater than or equal to 0. What would happen then? Which means expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square should be always greater than or equal to 0, because this is nothing but variance. Now finally, what we write here is expectation of x square should always be greater than or equal to expectation of x whole square. Okay. Yeah. So let us take one problem. Find mean and variance of example 2.8. So let us go to the example 2.8. Here it is. Yes. Now here, to just find out mean and variance of this random variable x. Okay, mean and variance of random variable x. So x is a random variable with the given PM of px of x. How it is defined? Like this. So let us write here. Now, x is a random variable, PMF is given what? Px of x equal to 1/9 if integer x belongs to -4 to +4, if I am not wrong, 0 otherwise, isn't it? So let me check. So 1 by 9, if x is integer in the range minus 4 to plus 4, 0 otherwise. Now, so here we have a random variable x and its PMF. We have to find mean and variance of this random variable. So to find out mean and variance, one should know what? PMF. Without PMF, you cannot find out mean or variance. So that is importance of PMF. It's very, very important. First of all, so let me write the formula of mean. Expectation of x. Please remember, they're asking mean and variance of x, not y. Okay, you can find out y also if you want. So expectation of x equal to mu or mu x, that equal to what is the formula? Summation over x, x into px of x. Here px of x is a constant because it's 1 by 9, no? So that's why. Now x varies from where to where? Small x varies from where to where? Minus 4 to plus 4. How many numbers are there? Minus 4 to plus 4, no? Now summation equal to summation. X varies from minus 4 to plus 4. X into, what is px of x? 1 by 9. Now here you can do like this. You can write 1 by 9 outside the summation because it is a constant. 1 by 9 summation over x equal to minus 4 to plus 4 x. What do you mean by this? What the answer would be? 1 by 9. Now x equal to minus 4. X equal to next minus 3. Minus 4. Minus 3. Minus 2. Minus 1. Plus 0. Plus 1. Plus 2. Plus 3. Plus 4. What would happen? Everything cancels out. What do you get? 1 by 9 into 0. That is 0. Here mean is 0. It is a constant. Mean can be 0. Mean can be any value. It can be negative also. But variance is always non-negative. Now we got mean mu equal to 0. Okay? Or expectation of x equal to 0. Next, what is the variance? Now variance, let me write all the formulas of variance. The variance formula is summation over x, x minus mu whole square px of x. This is the first formula. Now by using this formula, here what is mu? I got 0. Mu is 0. Now simply I can substitute x into x minus mu is 0. Simply x square into what? Px of x. What is this? It is called second moment. So if mean is 0, variance is simply what? If mean is 0, variance is simply equal to what? Second moment. That is expectation of x square. So simply you have to find out sigma x square is nothing but summation over x equal to where to where? Minus 4 to plus 4 x square into what is px of x? Again 1 by 9. So we can write 1 by 9 outside the summation. Summation from minus 4 to plus 4 x square. Now what would happen here? 1 by 9 summation minus 4 whole square 16 plus minus 3 whole square 9 plus 4 plus 1 plus 0 plus 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16. You calculate all these things. What do you get? So 16 16 32, you calculate this, it may be around 60 by 9. I am not sure about the answer. Please, you calculate yourself. But this concept is correct. Okay. I am not sure about this answer. Okay. You do calculations. Now, otherwise, What is the formula of variance? I told you one more formula, that is expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. This is nothing but mu. That equal to 0. Now this is cancels out. That equal to simply expectation of what? X square. Okay. So in this way also the answer is simply expectation of x square. So we have found out a mean and variance of the given random variable. Okay. Now here, so we'll see some other topics. Now mean and variance of a linear function of a random variable. I told you in the previous classes, random variable y is a linear function of random variable x. I'm talking about linear functions only. In this form, y equal to some constant into x plus some other constant into b, some other constant b. A and b are scalars, okay, or some constants. Now, can you tell me what is the expectation of this random variable y and what is the variance of this random variable y? Okay, so let us calculate expectation. Now we are writing something like this. So we have a random variable y, which is a function of random variable x. Now I want to ask you, what is the mean and variance of random variable y, which is a function of random variable x? Okay. Now without finding what? Pm of what? Y. So let us see how it happens. Now I just want to know what is the expectation of y. Okay. Here I want to know expectation of what is y? Ax plus b. Okay. Ax plus b. Now, please, I am repeating one more time, how to replace these things. Expectation of x equal to summation over small x into px of x. What is small x? Any possible value of capital X. You always compare with this original formula of mean or expectation. So here, what changes do we make? We write small x, capital X with small x, and later we write PMF. That's it. Summation over small x. Okay. Now here, if you compare these two, what we have here is, in place of capital X, I have A into capital X plus B. Okay. Now, can you tell me expectation of A into capital X plus B could be, formula is what now? Summation over small x. Now what do you write? A into small x plus B into Px of x. Here, what I have done here? Wherever there is capital X, I have written small x. That's it. No more changes. A means A only, B means B only. So wherever there is capital X, make it small x and take summation over small x, write the PMF. That is how we find out the mean of any random variable. It could be anything. Now if you remember properly, in the case of variance, what I have done? Variance is nothing but expectation of x minus mu whole square. What I have written? Summation over x. I have written this as x minus mu whole square. I just written capital X with small x. Everything else is same. Please remember this. Okay. Now, so coming back to this. Now, summation over x, I am writing separately. A into x into px of x plus summation over x b into px of x. Now, so I told you already a and b are constants. Let me write here. Finally, expectation of y is equal to summation over x a into x into PMF plus summation over x b into PMF. Since a and b are constant, you can write outside a summation a into summation over x x into px of x plus b into summation over x px of x. Now what is this? That is nothing but expectation of x. What is this? That is sum of all PMFs, which is equal to 1. Isn't it? So that's why, so expectation of y that equal to expectation of ax plus b that equal to a into expectation of x plus b. Here this will be 1, you are left with only b. Now what a conclusion. Now the question is, I want us a question. What is the expectation of any constant? That is the wrong work. What is the expectation of any constant? What is the expectation of 1, 2, 3, so on and so on? What is that? You find out. Now, we are done with expectation of y. Now, what is the variance of y? So that means variance of ax plus b. Okay. Now generally what is the variance, generally we write variance formula, what we write? Sigma x square equal to summation over x x minus mu whole square px of x. Now, what do you write here? What is your answer? So, we have so many formulas, you can use any formula. What is one more formula? Expectation of x square minus mu square. Expectation of x square minus mu square. Okay? Now, let us use this formula. Simplified formula, no? Now what we have here is, so we can solve by using any formula, but before proceeding further, let me recall what is the expectation or mean. What is the mean value here? Mu y or mu y. What is that? That is otherwise. So what is expectation of a plus b? A into expectation of x plus b. We have just now proved this. Now, so with this, what we can write here is sigma y square equal to, we are finding the variance of y, no? What do you write? Summation ax plus b minus its mean. Ax plus b, something like this. Ax plus b minus its mean. What is the mean of this ax plus b? A into expectation of x minus b whole square into px of x. You try to understand this very carefully. B, B cancels out. What do you get? Summation over x, ax minus a into expectation of x whole square into px of x. You got this? Can I explain one more time? Here variance of y equal to summation over x, this variable minus its mean into mean whole square into this PMF. Generally, what is the variance of x? X minus its mean whole square into px of x. Here, what is the variance of y now? That variable y minus its mean whole square into PMF of x, because everything is in terms of x. That's why we write summation over x PMF of x. Now, here, so a is common, right? I mean, a square is common. You can take a square outside the summation. Summation over x, x into x minus ex whole square into px of x. Or you can also write this as a square into summation over x, x minus mu whole square into px of x. What is this? That is nothing but variance of x. So in the simple form, what would happen? So variance of y equal to a square into variance of x. Expectation of y equal to a into expectation of x plus b. It is called linearity property. These are also very, very, very important. The proof is very simple. You follow the basic definitions of the mean and variance. These are the two formulas which are very, very important. Okay, so we stop here. Thank you.